Now it's time for the boys to take center stage. You're taking a look at head coach Boyd there on the sidelines. His team 2-0 in district play, and his lineups will as follow. First of all, the Panthers. It's Ali at guard, Wagner at guard, Aquilo also at guard. The forwards are Henry and Milhorn. Now for the Wolves, it's Waheed Wilson are the two guards, Jordan Miller at 6'1", a forward, Mikhail Land at 6'2", the other, and Opaly, number 55, is a center. He is 6'5", and these Wolves hoping for another good game and staying on top of the district race against AAA Academy, who in their own right is a pretty good team in this district. And the jump at center stage is won by Imam. And right off the bat, three ball, quarter pocket, number 13, Milhorn, gets the tray.
Didn't waste any time, put that up.
And we're going to see a lot of this tonight, Coach. And that is Jalen Wilson, who averages 10 points a ball game. Four players not playing tonight for Coach Boyd. And one of those is Griffin, the 6'3 senior who averages close to 10 points a ball game. So he will be missed. Ali goes inside the paint, and it's stolen away nicely by Land.
Oh, yeah, just pulled it away from him.
I asked Coach Boyd, I said, well, how are we running our offense tonight? He goes, you've seen us play. You know what we do. I said, you roll the basketball on the court and let them start shooting. There's a shot by Land is missed. He says, no, they get the basketball themselves.
That's right. Just get it out of the rack, don't you?
Yep. Yeah, I'm not going to roll them. I'm not going to give them anything.
Yeah, this game's a little bit quicker than the last one. We'll be able to see that as far as it goes.
And let's see if he was stepping on the baseline or no. Called a foul on number 15, Jalen Wilson, the 5'11 sophomore. This team, the Wolves, averaging about 31 or so points or percentages from three-point land. Henry, the miss. Again, Land, the rebound. Doing a good job underneath and clearing the glass as the Wolves looking for their first points here in the first quarter.
Little zone now.
Land trying to work it inside to Opaly. Opaly, he's got the size advantage underneath, trying to work against Henry. In the corner, in and out. And the rebound brought down by number 3, Aquilo.
They had some offensive position there inside, but it didn't look like they looked into to him very much.
No. And here comes the speed, Waheed. Waheed changes hands and misses. And a rebound by Henry. And stolen right back and put up and in by Waheed. Nice job defensively for the steal.
Yeah, he had four zone people down there, one of theirs, and he forced it. Well, there you take your time and you get it spread out and get the ball to somebody and take it down and score.
Henry called for the traveling. Watch Waheed, number 11, just timed his jump perfectly. Waheed runs the point. Land over on the left side. Still haven't got it inside to Opaly yet. And now he switches sides, and he's kind of running across that lane trying to post up high, but the Panthers have kept him in check. Land from three.
Again, it doesn't look like they're too concerned about getting the ball inside.
No.
They're looking for the shot outside.
Land hits 32% from three-point land. Back the other way, and that is missed by Wagner. So after hitting their first three-pointer, North Hills has missed their last two jump shots.
Looks like we're going to have a few shots taken tonight.
You think? That is taken by, is that a Land? No, check that. That was Jalen Wilson who missed the three-pointer. And inbounding will be Sebastian Wagner. This is a prep school. It's free. You got to get in. And there's about 2,000 people on a waiting list to get into the middle school, the coach was telling me.
And it's very prestigious academic-wise.
Aquilo on the baseline, knocked around. Opaly had the offensive rebound. Waheed fires right corner. He gets it back. Around they go. Land hit one already from three. Opaly, he's working really hard trying to get the ball on the inside, but they're going to keep shooting deep. if you're a big man on this Wolf team, you're in a world of hurt because they're going to shoot it around the outside perimeter all they can.
Yeah, that's kind of, if I'm going to score, I'm going to have to get it off the board myself.
Mm-hmm.
But you realize you're going to have plenty of opportunities because they're going to be shooting the ball.
Mustafa Ali, 00, pulls back and scores.
Nice little shot.
Yep, nicely done.
Challenging. Yeah. Boyd wants timeout.
Yep, timeout in a hurry.
I don't know if he's going to tell the guys to look inside every now and then or not. But, I mean,
well.
That does get frustrating as a big man to roll across, seal your man, and they don't even look at you.
D. Boyd, who is not shy about playing much tougher teams in pre-district, he'll tell you, look, I got to play as many tough games as I can to prep my kids for hopefully postseason. 12th year, only coach in school history. He was at Mountain View College for 5 years. Took the Wolves to the 3A state championship in 05-06. Has coached 7 All-State players. He's so understated, let me tell you. And he loves to talk about the fact his team isn't very good or I don't know what we're going to do. And then they end up winning by 20. But
he wants to lull you in that sense. Oh, hey, we could beat them. Yeah. They're not any good. Coach didn't think they're any good.
I know. And there is Kenneth Gober, who also coached the girls game a while ago. The head coach for the girls. Not able to make it. He came in, stepped in, double duty. Played at Texas Wesleyan himself in 07-09 and played at Trinity Valley. Trinity Valley, what is their mascot?
I don't know.
The Cardinals.
The Cardinals. I missed that one.
We're tied at 5. Waheed over to Land. Land splits the zone. The runner missed. Rebound stolen away by the Wolves and lifted in nicely was number 15, Wilson, his first 2 points of the ball game.
You know, that time they didn't look inside. They took it inside, but they didn't look to the big man. 2 attempts they drove and got a little bit closer.
John Henry misses that. Not much there. Waheed left wide open. Bounced around and controlled by the Panthers. Ali dribbles out of his own shoes there.
Yep.
Luckily, he kept control. I mean, that could have been a travel. It could have been a turnover.
Yeah, he never had it when he was moving, so it was.
Aquilo, the drive. One and done as Dequan Waheed comes down with the rebound. Back over to Land, left again. Open. Missed the three-pointer. Ball is loose. Stay away from our table, please.
Please.
Got a substitution as Aquilo will go out and Canales will come in. Lucas was being taped right about tip-off time. Lucas a little bit bigger.
Coach Boyd doesn't have to tell his players to shoot the ball.
Oh, no. The question is, when it comes down to crunch time, who's going to shoot it?
Yeah.
That's the question. Richardson, the 5'7 junior, number 5, just there in the middle bottom part of the screen, has just checked in. Waheed, a nice little drive, can't make it happen, and Henry drags down the rebound.
North Hills has to be careful. Every time they get a rebound, there's one or two of the Ranchview players, you know, trying to steal it inside underneath their basket. Oh, little foul.
Wagner in good possession, but he was hacked and will go to the line to shoot 2. Ranchview has scored 994 points, but they've given up about 200 more. That is good for Wagner. So he's 1 out of 1.
Again, the boys are pulling their players back, not being on the free throw lane when they're shooting.
This must be a North Hills thing.
Maybe. Maybe because Gover put it in with the girls a while ago. Just knowing that he needed to have it ready.
Well, there's 5 guys on the bench for Coach Boyd to go for, and there's about 4 that they can pick from on the North Hills bench. Also coming in is Wright. This is from the outside, in and out by Richardson.
Almost banked it in.
Got a couple of 5'7s, 5'5s on this team, the Wolves do.
Right idea. Fake the shot and then try to get it inside. Just couldn't handle it.
Tried to hit Milhorn crossing underneath. Nothing but a turnover in the books. Under 2 minutes to go. First quarter of action. Team's a little rusty on the jump shots.
And North Hills just running a little zone.
Another three-pointer missed by Wright. But like you said, North Hills has to be prepared on that missed shot because there's always a wolf in your face.
Somebody's there. Yep. Wolf at the door.
Ali for three. Count it. Second three-pointer in the first quarter for the Panthers. And they're on top by three. Another pass that Land has to fight for to control. This is Wright, number 21, back to Richardson. Wright and Richardson, they're about 5'7 each, 5'5, 5'7. And a holding foul against one of the Panthers.
They've tried penetrating a little bit more. Again, they just haven't tried passing inside.
No, I don't think we've seen O'Pelli once get one inside to post up on.
No.
Richardson out the Land. Richardson, the lefty, scores. So he gets a three-pointer, the fourth three-pointer overall in this game in the first quarter.
That wasn't even close to the line, was it? A few feet behind it.
Yeah, totally. Tied at 10. Panthers. The drive, is it a charge? Yes, it is.
A charge.
And it's going to go against Wagner, who says we can't play defense.
Well, there's some teams the coaches stress taking charges, and you hate to drive against them. And you just have to be careful. You got to take your time. You know they're going to take a charge, so be ready.
One thing that we've seen when we've seen some Irving schools play is the hand check.
Yeah.
And in this particular, at least in the first quarter, you don't see anybody trying the hand check because, as we all know by now, they call those as a foul.
Yeah,
Wright.
I'm glad they went back to calling those.
Wright at the buzzer. No.
Good.
All right. Out of the gates quickly. Tied at 10. Back for the second quarter in a moment. Well, a 10-10 tie after one period of play. Rob Willman with you, along with G.W. Melton, sitting in tonight for your ICTN twin bill. We had the ladies first. Ranchview victorious, and that one got out to a good lead at the half and kind of put it in cruise control in the second. If you've never seen these 4A Wolves play before, you're going to see a lot of that right there. A lot of jump shots.
A lot of three-point attempts. They don't look inside. They're going to throw it up.
And that's good by Richardson, his second three-pointer for the 5'7 junior.
I thought they were going to put a little pressure on there, but they just picked him up a little further out, not much pressure.
Actually, with the lineup you see out here now, North Hills has a much taller team. One was going to call a foul, one a turnover, and it's going to end up being a foul on Richardson, number five, called reaching in. And that'll put Henry to the free throw line.
I think he's calling it on the floor. Yeah, he called it on the floor.
Okay. Coach Gober. Waxahachie native.
Waxahachie. Another one of those words mispronounced quite often.
Mm-hmm. Ali being pressured outside, so they give it to the wing and missed by Milhorn.
That's one of those, if I shot that one, I'd be saying, oh, that was a pass to you. You got to get in there and get it.
Wilson with the three-pointer. He averages 36% from the three-point line. And I was talking to Coach D. Boyd about the three-point line and the percentages, and I said, hey, 3 out of 10, you know, he goes, 33%, you know, is usually the mark. He says, but you know what? He says, now because so many three-point shots are taken, not just here but overall, he goes, now you're looking at 40% as being the benchmark.
Yeah, they get better as they go.
Bounce pass inside, blocked nicely by Opili. He says, well, I guess I can play some D if they're not going to give it to me inside. Wilson forcing the issue, draws the foul. There was at least three Panthers surrounding him on the drive. There is the block by Opili, the 6'5 senior.
Good strong block.
Mm-hmm. Wilson goes to the line to shoot two.
Man, that's too close. Free throw line's too close. Need to back it up. When the three-point shot first came out, it was kind of unusual to hit that many threes because people hadn't been shooting that far out.
Jalen, just a sophomore, hits 1 out of 2. Averages about 70% from the free throw line. Right at about 6.5 minutes before intermission. 10-4A district game here on ICTN. The long shot missed by Ali. One and done as the Wolves clear the boards. A 7-0 run by Ranchview. They go all the way around the horn. Everyone touches it. Wilson left alone. Missed it. Land was there. Land and one of the Panthers were fighting for it. And last touch by the Panthers. Wagner got his hand on it. Wilson again left open. And they said two.
Yep.
Just two.
Just had a little screen for him to go around. Nobody went out with him. He gets a three.
Wilson said, he sure it wasn't a three. And Coach Boyd's like, you sure it wasn't a three? And he's kind of doing that. Let's
watch 55 set the screen.
Okay. Opili does a great job. That's no out. One even goes after him. And toe must have been on the line.
Kind of hard to tell from that angle. It was close. It probably
don't know if we have a ground level of that shot or not, but Coach Boyd is like, scoot back, just a whisker.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about. But they're on a 9-0 run right now?
Yeah, 9-0. It was 10-10 at the quarter.
Looking at their three-point percentages, Waheed's at 30%, Wilson's 36%. The freshman right 29, lands 32%. So they got a lot of guys on the team that are right around the 30 mark and a couple above it. North Hill fans making a move over. The Wolves winning both times. The school met last season 73-40, 70-38. First time they've met this year. Little press, Coach. Not a trap, just kind of a man-to-man pressure.
Yeah, I don't know if it was a press per se, or they just stepped that way. And North Hills was expecting a press, so they ran a press break.
And it worked.
We'll see next time. You know, if it was a controlled press, or if they just set up that way.
And Wagner was like all alone. There's Wilson. Hello, Mr. Wilson. Another three. I can see why he shoots about 36% from that range.
No.
Got a nice jump shot and a good look. And at 5'11", and just a sophomore. Get some height on that jump. High post screen by Canales, and Canales double dribbles. Caught it on the bounce and then picked it up and dribbled some more.
Well, I can see why they're not that concerned about looking inside as well as they're shooting outside right now.
No. 10-point Ranchview lead, looking to expand. Remember, it's 10-10 at the quarter. Dangerous cross-court pass. Wilson again missed, and I believe Land's going to be called for going over the back. Yeah, Land is called for the foul. And we've got some new substitutes, some fresh players coming in off the bench. Evan Atkins, 5'11 sophomore. You see them there, number 44. Also number 12, Malachi Jones, now in the lineup.
Yeah, it looks like they're just matching up with them. Not really an organized press.
Matthew Chin, number 2, also a new face. This for the Panthers.
I think North Hills just wants some more of a continuity there and bringing the ball down the court. Everybody knew where they're going.
Ali against Adkins. Ali left open. Canales gave him the screen. O'Paley with the rebound, stays in bounds long enough to give it over to Richardson. Richardson to Wilson. I'd put two men on him on that corner. Yeah. Around they work it.
Yeah, they work around the outside. They make you work on defense.
Richardson, his third three-pointer of the ball game. He's really taking advantage of the situation, isn't he?
Oh, yeah.
Wagner, baseline. Boy, had to force that one. Richardson with the rebound. Richardson only averaging, 27% from three-point line. Wagner rebounds. Chin doesn't want to shoot it. So instead, he kicks it out to Ali, who has Wagner there at the top, and the new guy, Jones, guarding him. Ali blocked from behind from O'Paley. Wow. I mean, at 6'5", not a lot of guys are going to be able to get past
him. Yeah, going in. Nice little block here.
All ball, too.
Kind of got it with his forearm.
Two more guys coming in, Thompson and Waheed. Waheed back in. O'Paley sits down. Wilson sits down.
Ali did a good job attacking, I guess. I hate when kids go back here and try to bounce the ball instead of grabbing it. Had he grabbed the ball, you know, the other team wouldn't have had a chance to get it. He got it back, but, you know, you catch the ball and put it on the floor under control. But that's hard to get kids to do.
Closing in on 3 minutes. Chin from 3 points. 3-point line missed. I think a foul's going to be called on Henry going over the back. That'll be a foul against Henry. The fouls are almost even, team fouls. 4 against the visitors, 5 against the home team Wolves.
The Wolves have scored a 15-2 in this quarter so far.
Starts raining threes. Richardson surprised he didn't take it. Now he does. Rebound by Henry. Ali cut off at the top of the key. Instead, the little runner by Chin is missed, or Aquilo, excuse me. Aquilo gets it back and makes it count.
And official injury. Timeout.
Yep. Aquilo, his first 2 points, and it appears it may be Thompson, sophomore, got caught an elbow. Watch number 10.
See here if we can see it.
Right there.
Well, did a good job of hustling, getting the ball. Missed a shot, got a rebound. Attacks it, scores.
So it's down to 11. North Hills, plenty of time to cut that lead down even more if they can stop the shooting of the Wolves.
Yeah. Let's spread that out, spread that zone, and keep getting the outside shots.
And in and out.
In and out.
Ali. Cross dribble.
Good
nice
pass.
Little pass and a fast break. Missed by Henry. Oh, he was wide open. That's one of those gray hair moments.
Oh, yeah.
As a coach.
You work, you get hard, got a shot, and he misses an easy one. Could have been a little push foul there, but he let that go.
Richardson, another one. His fourth in the first half.
That's kind of hard to stop. You either got to, you know, spread your zone out and, you know, give the inside open, or play man, tie it all over.
Tighter D, obviously, Coach, right? Get in their face and have to leave the middle open.
We played a team one time, and I told the kid, you don't let that guy shoot. He was in his face all the way. Cal pulls up about 4 feet outside three, pops it. I just look at him and say something. He said, Coach, I know you couldn't do anything more. I mean, that's all you can do sometimes. You know, they're going to hit some shots. You can play some of the best defense in the world, but they're going to put it in sometimes.
Jones with the runner. The senior with the basket here in the first half. Closing in on a minute.
We need to 4 in the second quarter. Ranchview's outscored.
Chin rolling right. Really an awkward shot.
Yeah, not a good shot. You can't force those shots.
Wagner comes in. Ali goes out. Would say that they might try to wait for the last shot, but not this team.
I don't think so. They might get last three shots.
Inside and out. Come on, Richardson, you've scored 4 from 3. How about one more? He's just sitting over here on the left side waiting. Wide by Waheed. You know, Waheed played a lot in the first quarter, and we didn't see much of him until now. So
that's in a while.
Chin behind the back. Aquilo. And a charge called against Luke Milhorn, number 13, as he was trying to find John Henry underneath. Good D by the Wolves.
Yeah, good position. Hold your ground. They come in out of control. You get the charge. You get the ball. Now, here rolling the ball, it gets you down the court further before the clock starts.
You just have to know when it stopped and when it's going.
Yeah.
Will Heat at the buzzer. Not going to count.
I don't think it would have counted yet.
No. So a good second quarter. A 20-4 difference by the Wolves in that second quarter, and they lead it 30-14 at the break. Stay with us, folks. We'll be back with the third quarter. Highlights and stats. Stay with us.
No 1-1s that quarter.
No. Well, thanks to a 20-4 second quarter, the Ranchview Wolves are on top 30-14 at the break. Highlights, let's roll them. We'll start with North Hills, and they got off to a pretty good start themselves. First man up was Luke Milhorn with the tray. And then also Ali, 00 with the tray. But when you talk about outside shooting and 3 points, you can't say anything unless you talk about the Wolves. Land hits one from the outside to get things started. Then you got Richardson. Took him a while to heat up, but when he did, bam. Then Wilson. This guy shoots over 35% from three-point land. And then you got Richardson again from the top of the key, and that's how the ball rolls when you take on the Wolves. Scoring-wise, Ali had 5, Wagner 4, Milhorn, and Aquilo, your other scores. For the Wolves, Richardson 12, all of those three-pointers, Coach. Wilson had 11, Land, Waheed, and Jones rounds out the scoring. So if you're the Panthers and you're trying to stop this shooting display, what do you do?
Well, you know, I'd say go to a man-to-man. You know, they haven't tried to get it inside a whole lot. Go to man-to-man, just play tight and not help off. Pick certain ones that you don't want to shoot the ball and say you don't leave that person.
Ali has it. Corner shot missed by Wagner.
But they've been playing a zone, so, you know, if you're going to keep a zone, you just have to spread that zone out and know where people are and don't leave them open.
Waheed. Nice move to the hoop. He just more or less just kind of hung there long enough for the defender to go past him and laid it up for 2 points. So they're on the board very quickly. Wagner, a stutter step behind the back. Aquilo going to his right, now back to his left. Ali has land on him. Ali left open thanks to the pick and he scores. So a nice offensive setup by the Panthers.
Probably has a nice little stroke.
And I don't think Coach D. Boyd liked that play defensively on his side. Let's watch 55. Watch 55. Does he pick him up? No, he gets to him too late. And that was what Coach Boyd was talking about to his senior.
Yeah, he was laying too far back.
Yeah, didn't come up to meet the shooter. And everybody's laughing. So, you know, there's a Boydism in there somewhere.
Yeah.
He's saying something funny.
He's probably coached that before.
Oh, yeah.
How once do you or play twice. That?
O'Pelly, he leads the team in rebounds. He averages just over six a ball game. He was waiting for the rebound instead of coming up to make the play defensively.
Yeah.
So a coaching moment, a teaching moment, if you will. Not even a minute gone by in the third quarter.
We're still in the zone. Yeah.
Waheed, oh boy, he kept the leg down just enough. Waheed trying to work around that, trying to find something to dive into, but can't. Miller, who started the game, didn't see much action after that. Land, now he's on the near side corner for three, and that's the way the mop flops in this game.
Yeah, they kind of flood that zone over there, and you know, they've got to get the top man to pick the gap on the wing, and then the bottom man's got to take the one down low, and it just didn't happen that time. So it left him wide open.
Bounce pass, nicely done to Wagner.
Nice little play. Should have had some backside help on that. Sure coach is not too happy about that.
Thing about North Hills, they have to run a set play offensively to try to free themselves to get that open look.
Yeah, because they don't have the athletic advantage to go over somebody or to create that often. They work and get themselves open and hopefully, you know, get a shot to fall.
Land threw that one over the outstretched arms of Waheed. A turnover. And North Hills comes right back. That's a long shot, and that's going to be 3-1. Wagner made the three-pointer, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Yeah, that wasn't close to the line. It was.
No, that was way out there.
Watch this replay here.
Wilson hit him too.
Chance for a four-point play. Didn't get it. He didn't want to be selfish. He just take three that time.
You know, he's the only one that has been to the line tonight. That's only his third free throw.
That's got to be able to shoot some free throws.
Wilson fake the drive. Now Waheed will drive. Something a little different here in the second half, Coach.
Yeah, penetrate.
Waheed with six. Ali backs up.
Yep. Stepped out. Put that foot back, stepped out of bounds.
Presence, you got to know where you're at all the time.
Yep.
It's like that time in the first half, the backcourt.
Backcourt line.
You have to remember where you're at. The blue line is the half one, not the white one.
Uh-huh.
Miller. Blocked.
Shot. Nice block.
And a clean block. An air ball by Milhorn. But turn right back.
Speeding it up.
Aquilo at the point. Dishes Ali all the way around the corner to Wagner.
They're doing some of the same things that Ranchview was doing. Just didn't hit the shot. Spread it out, move it around, take over the shot.
Charge. That was John Henry drawing the charge against Land. Waheed sets down. And they bring Malachi
Jones.
Let's
look at the charge and see if it was. Could have been.
A little closer than that one in the girls' game, right?
Yeah, oh yeah. Charge can go either way. Depends on how the referee feels at the time, to tell you the truth.
Bounce past baseline. Boy, that was a tough shot for Wagner to try to make.
That's a hard play to get in there, and then you got to come up underneath and hit the backboard just right with the spin.
Well, Aquilo did a good job throwing.
Look at that. Pass it right through. He just couldn't get it on the board. He was putting the right spin on it. If he got the board, it would have gone in.
By the time Wagner got to it, he was at a really tough angle.
Yeah, yeah. But they did a good job of working the play, getting people open.
Wagner,
one out of two,
gets back on the plus side of the free throws. Three out of five. They're still down by 15 as the running gun Wolves reload and start again. A travel call against Wilson.
Yeah, North Hills has been in the man-to-man the last few times. That's why they've been moving the ball and penetrating more, trying to take it in. Which we'll just have to wait and see if that's going to be advantageous to North Hills or not.
Right.
With them trying to drive more instead of shooting a three.
Wright is back in for the Wolves. Bounce pass, near side, three-pointer, count it for Ali. His second tray of the ball game. He's now at 10 points. It's a 12-point difference.
Ali's got a nice little shot. That's the first time I remember seeing 55 Opelay getting the ball and doing something with it on offense.
They involved him offensively, yeah. Didn't they? Wagner's going to be called for slapping Miller across the hand. Opelay says, hey, you finally gave it to me.
Yeah.
I'm going to shoot it.
Even though I'm outside a little bit, I'm going to put it up.
That's the first time he's touched it, isn't it?
Second.
On like a set play. His first 2 points of the ball game. Ali with the miss.
They may have made contact with that ball going up, too. Threw him off.
Missed by Henry, last touched by the Panthers.
Still a man.
Been a subdued crowd tonight.
Yeah, hadn't been a lot of.
Not a lot of.
You'd think it would be. I mean, you'd think they'd be going crazy. I threw it into him again, go, Rob.
Yeah, go ahead, take it, take it. Is not this time. More like a Richardson type shot. Wright. And he gets it to fall. Kenneth Wright, the freshman, his first 2 points.
I'll do that little runner there.
Yeah. What a difference from that first half, isn't it?
See him
pressure and drive to the basket instead of shooting from 30 feet out. Wagner has that one slapped around by Opelay. Leads the team in blocks. You can see why. Miller against Wagner, not a lot of room there. That's Richardson's range. Oh, look, even Richardson's driving the basketball.
Yeah. Yeah, I figured he would pull that one up and hit it.
He's going to take it from that corner. And it goes behind the backboard.
Didn't touch anything, but if it goes behind the backboard, that's an out of bounds.
Evan Atkins, number 44, checks in. And Miller will sit down. You know, maybe Coach Boyd's thinking ahead of time, postseason play, you know, playing teams where he will need to maybe drive it to the hoop.
Yeah. You work on that sometimes.
Is that away from the play? Must have been.
Must have. I didn't see who did it.
Oh, number 22.
Tom 22. I didn't see who did it.
Canales, yeah. Must have been trying to set the block.
Yeah, may have been.
Got charged for the charge. Richardson again, just kind of yo-yoing up and down and moving around. Opelay up top. Trying to go inside to Evans or Atkins.
Opelay must like this offense. He gets to touch it every now and then.
Yep, there's a travel call. Jones. Coach Boyd This guy has made the playoffs in all 11 seasons of varsity play. Pretty good.
Can't beat that.
Yep. No other sport in this school has done that. And Wagner tried to go baseline again. That would have been a pretty play.
Uh-huh. Good walk.
Travel again by Malachi Jones.
Got to get the ball down sooner.
Well, so many players take their shots, you know, when you get in there, it's like I got to put a couple up.
Yeah. It's my turn. I'm going to try this out.
Wagner comes up with an offensive rebound and a travel.
I didn't see his feet. Must have. Must have shuffled a little bit. Made a nice little move.
He did.
Could have worked in the NBA.
They don't call travel, do they?
Not very often.
I don't think that's in the rule book. Actually, if you look in the rule book, it's been erased. It's not even there.
Yeah.
Someone says, what was there at one time? Atkins misses a three. Ali moves left. In and out. Hopefully rebounds. One and done. Atkins tried to get it to Richardson, but had it knocked away. Plenty of time in this scenario.
Yeah,
quite opposite of when we saw the Wolves and Roosevelt play a few years ago. Well, this place is rocking.
Oh, I bet.
Going for the final shot. Wright has it. Wilson at the buzzer. And that's it. So we have finished three, headed for four. Our score, the Wolves 41, the Panthers 25. Back with the final quarter in a moment. Before we head into the final stanza of the ball game, let's go ahead and thank our sponsor for the ICTN Game of the Week, Gerald Stavely Dry Cleaning, the charter sponsor of the ICTN Game of the Week. We appreciate the Stavely family and their support since day one here in the city of Irving. Well, the tell of the tape so far, Coach, has been the second quarter. That's when Ranchview outscored them 20-6. Otherwise, both teams are dead even in the first and third quarters.
Yep, North Hills going back into a zone now. We'll see, you know, how Ranchview handles that. They're going to start popping from outside again. In the third quarter, they were trying to penetrate more.
Well, there's no hurry.
Kind of feeling it out.
Yep.
We're going to do.
Richardson. Panthers almost let that one get away.
Yeah,
they all just looked at each other.
There's three up there. Who wants it, huh?
Yeah. Ali, the runner. Capelli with the rebound.
Capelli's averaging about six rebounds a game.
Atkins. Is he going to be called for the charge?
No. Call it a block.
Blocking foul against Henry. And
see,
Atkins will go to the
here.
Line.
Has him drive.
Didn't have that left leg set, I don't think.
I guess.
From that angle.
Again, it's.
You sound
never know
like,
what they're
you sound
gonna
like
call.
A coach over here.
Yeah. You never know what they're going to call.
Richardson sets down. Land comes back in. Coach Boyd has so many guys on the bench that can shoot the jump shot. It's this continual switch of scenery out there.
That's a nice thing to have. Somebody's not hitting. I got some other guys over here. They're going to shoot and they'll put it in.
Whereas Gober has had to pretty much stick with his five. He might bring one extra guy in, but he's He's got to stay with what he's got. Quillo, good shot. His second basket of the night.
Quillo come in, hit you one every now and then. That's what you got to have.
Right. Back ironed. Henry brings it down, and here come the Panthers running again. Wagner for three. Wagner's carrying this team offensively.
There it goes from outside again.
Yeah, that doesn't take long, does it?
No. Back off a little bit, and they're going to put it outside. Play them tight man-to-man, they're going to penetrate on it.
Quillo over in the corner. A little runner with the left hand.
Left hand run.
Gets his own rebound. Doesn't like his odds.
A little foul there, a little foul there.
Wagner pushed by Atkins underneath.
Still got a long way, so we'll go to 1-1. Relative to a few
fouls
called. Wow,
yeah, 3 points each. I mean, three team fouls each.
Now that we've said that, it's going to start.
He jinxed us.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
We're not accustomed to that, are we?
Ollie tried to get it inside, tried to penetrate and dish. Had too many hands there.
Yeah, well, Pally, he's a pretty good presence underneath. He's by far the biggest guy out there.
Yeah, he's got some size. Not just tallness, he's kind of thick and strong there, too, looks like.
Quillo, nice little head fake, and drew the big man out to draw the foul.
Yep, around him. It's hard for a big guy to guard somebody outside like that.
Yeah, they have their comfort zone in the paint, don't they?
Yeah. And if you back off of him, coach gets mad if you know, if he shoots outside.
Henry, offensive tip.
Yeah, nice little tip. Lucky he didn't get a foul call on that reach.
Wagner with the steal back on the other side. Puts it out. Hoop and a horn.
Block. And here come the fouls.
Thanks, coach.
See the replay on the drive. Good job going in. Steps over just a little bit too much body contact. Then gets the shot to fall. Gets a chance to step up the line for a three-point play.
15 of the 32 points have been scored by Mr. Wagner.
He's the one they want to go to hit it.
And he now has 16.
Made a three-point play out of the deal.
Yep. Last time they had a three-point play, what happened? The Wolves came right down and hit a three-pointer.
Yep. Now they're back in a man again. And they're trying to penetrate.
Wilson drives. And that's what happens. Here's the difference. I get, you know, obviously when the Panthers are in a zone and the Wolves are Ranchview's doing nothing but shooting outside shots, you don't have the opportunity to get as many fouls. But once you start driving, all bets are off.
Yeah, with the penetration, they're trying to penetrate to draw the foul or, you know, get the layup or the short shot.
And, you know, and perhaps Coach Gober's thinking, you know, if I make them try to shoot free throws and they don't make them,
yeah, I have a better chance now.
Then I have a better chance to come back. One out of two for Wilson. It's his first point of the second half, and it comes with about 5 minutes to go.
Yeah, defense-wise, you're trying to take away what they're more comfortable with. Of course, then Wilson comes back and kind of makes a foolish foul.
Yeah, that never works when you try to come from behind to jar the ball loose.
No.
A lot of times officials, even though it might be a clean hit, just the fact they think it's going to be a foul.
Yeah, I think he just put his hand in his back too, so that's a big thing.
Milhorn misses. 17 fouls now by the Wolves. Closing in on four here in the fourth period. A nice little runner by Waheed. He's now at 8 points, pretty close to his season average.
Yeah, making them penetrate, you know, for them it takes more time off the clock. You make them penetrate.
Three-pointer by Ali, his third three-pointer. That's how the game started. Pretty drive by Wilson.
And just not getting any help from the defense. You know, you've got to back off of them just enough to not let them penetrate. So watch the drive. Nobody's there. Nobody steps over to help.
Yep, Canales is too late. He's looking at the middle.
You've got certain defensive rules that you have to play. I know we used to play if the ball is, you know, one pass away, you know, you're 1 foot in the lane. If it's two passes away, you're in the middle of the basket, middle of the lane. And you're concentrating on the ball, not let the ball penetrate.
Take a look at the standings in the district race in 10-4A. AAA Academy at 3-0. According to Coach Gober of North Hills, he says they've got some athletes. They look like men on their team. They're pretty strong. Ranchview at 2-0. North Hills Prep 0-1. Hampton Prep and Summit International. Ranchview defeated Summit 79-34. And defeated Hampton 81-60. North Hills, they lost to AAA Academy by a big 81-43. And if you didn't join us for the girls' game, again, North Hills is a preparatory free public college prep charter school located here in Irving in Las Colinas, established in 97 as the first school in the Uplift Education Network, the largest charter school network in North Texas. Waheed, nice pass to land, blocked away, no call. Wagner with the block defensively. Ali holds on to it. Back to Wagner for three, too short, gets his own rebound. Puts
nobody
it up,
blocked him out.
Count it.
Just saying you don't block the shooter out. Shooter's the first one to know where the ball's gonna go. He shot the ball, so it's off, goes in, nobody blocks him out, gets the rebound, chance for another three-point play.
Watch it again, Coach. There's the.
Good job. Good hustle.
Well, they had Thompson in there. Remember Thompson, he took an elbow to the face back in the first half, came back in. And now they got O'Peely back in there. Wagner with the three-point play, 19 points.
Two three-point plays, I know. It was just recently for him.
Down by 12, the Wolves have kind of kept that cushion throughout. Wilson fouled before the shot by Wagner.
Still not enough backside help. I know, can't get the shot off, but you got to have some people sitting over there, you know, stopping them from going to the hole.
O'Peely wide open.
Wide open, yeah.
Oh, they didn't see him. They're so used to kicking it out high.
He's kind of invisible.
He is. I mean, he was literally 2 feet from the basket looking for the pass. So, you know, we got to shoot the three.
Yeah.
That's all there is to it.
Yeah, we hadn't shot one in a while.
No, we haven't. Kenneth Wright does the honors there.
Ali says, I'll put me one up.
Oh. 10 three-pointers tonight, Coach, by the Wolves. How about 11?
Oh, go to it.
O'Peely keeps it alive and well.
Yep. That would count as a rebound in my book for O'Peely. Hold it back, that's the ball again.
Land at the top. In and out. Canales rebounds, and there's no one there to.
So wait a minute, let me give it to somebody else.
Yeah. I'm not used to this. Three-pointer by Milhorn, his second three-pointer. This remains at 12. That cushion can't get any closer than 12. Because Ranchview has an answer for it every time.
Yeah.
Air ball by Richardson. Our man O'Peely with the rebound, and he's pushed out. Well, nope, they're going to say he stepped out of bounds.
He pivoted around and stepped out of bounds.
I thought maybe they were going to get Canales for the push. So the hot shooting by North Hills keeping them oh so close in this game. And now they're going to go to the free throw line as Ali is fouled.
Wilson didn't think he fouled him, but you never do. if North Hills can hit free throws and keep up, you know, they keep pulling back in this. Only down 12 points now.
Well, Wagner has shot them all but one tonight, free throw. So you don't know how anybody else can shoot.
No.
Ali made his.
Ali would be one I'd want up there shooting. Got a nice little shot.
Miller comes in for Wilson. Wilson with 13, right about his average. Mustafa Ali, second shot good.
Nice shot.
Yep, 2 for 2.
All down 10 points, you got about 2 minutes to play. Still plenty of time.
Boy, is that the third shot we've seen go in and out?
Been a few.
Ali doesn't like his odds, comes back out. Canales gives it back to him. Notice the Wolves kind of applying a little bit more pressure on top.
Yeah.
And Coach Gover says, I need a full timeout, please. Nope, a 30. He just wants a 30. Just long enough maybe to
settle him down, tell him, hey, you know, they're putting pressure on. You know, probably tell him, here's what we have to do. So maybe get some people open. We've got time. We just got to score.
A 10-point game with less than 2 minutes to go. Can next week's game be just as fun? Let's hope so. It's the boys, Nimitz at Irving. Coach Donaldson's group against Coach Perry. The replay times in February. Can they make something happen with a minute 42 to go? Live by the jump shot, die by the jump shot.
Yep.
That's Milhorn. There's that backdoor play, and they get it to work.
Got the fall this time. He didn't have as much of a contest at it, and got to be able to put the right spin on it and get it off the glass.
Well, they made it count after the timeout. So it's an 8-point difference with a minute 21 to go, but they're going to have to foul here pretty soon. I mean, they don't have, they got a lot to give, too.
Yeah,
that's the problem.
More. Yeah, they've, you know, they got to make Ranchview shoot the ball. If they're not going to shoot, they got to foul and make them step to the line and shoot it. So you have an opportunity to get the ball back and score yourself.
Maybe a minute of just a little bit too late. Waheed tried to go inside. And
so that's the thing, when you don't go inside very often, then you go in a situation like this, he's not used to handling it that well.
Yeah, O'Paley's all night wanting that shot, wanting that feed. He gets it without about a minute to go in the game. Ali way outside. Boy, that was not a good percentage shot. But somehow the Panthers get control of the ball. Last touch by the Wolves.
That looked like a big collision in there somewhere, but I don't know how it wound up them getting the ball.
Miller comes out, Land comes back in. Land a little bit better shooter. They're going to stack the inside, and that goes over the head of Henry, but they're going to call a foul, I think, on Jalen Wilson. If they do, then
I don't see how that would be a foul.
Henry goes to the line with under a minute to go.
Let's watch the replay on that, the inbounds. Yeah. I can see now. I thought they were both going for the ball. It was more, he was just kind of underneath and made contact with him.
So Wilson fouls out with 14 points. Might as well say a minute left in this game.
Now, still plenty of time.
Yeah, they could cut this thing to, what, 6 points?
Yep, 6 points if they hit the free throws. Maybe seven. I mean, five now.
Henry yet to score a point tonight. That was his first shot at the free throw line as well.
Very important that Ranchview blocks out. You don't want to let them get a rebound.
Yeah, you notice they they were underneath the glass this time.
Oh, yeah. They're shooting the ball. You got to make sure they don't get it.
Full court press.
Putting the pressure on. See what they can handle it.
To Land. going over to right. Now back out the land. Land is fouled by Ali with 46.9 seconds to go. And now we go to the 1-1.
So now you've accomplished what you want. They're having to shoot the ball. They can't stall it right here. They've got to shoot the free throws.
All of Land's points have been behind the arc. Makes that free throw. He's now got 10 points. Really not a bad free throw shooting night by either team. Just not a lot of them for the Wolves. Not a lot of attempts, per se. But it's back to 8 again.
Oh.
Wow, my. Wagner, another 3. Six-point game. And a foul in the backcourt.
Yeah, that's where you want to foul them. You don't want to let them use time bringing the ball down the court. You foul them back there. Yep. Swatch the 3 as he pulls up. He elevates and gets that thing to fall. Nice little shot. Put him within 6 points. Now, again, you hope that they, you know, miss the free throw, shoot the 1-1.
Basket is good by Richardson, his first free throw attempt as well. And right now, Coach, the Wolves are making the free throws count down the stretch.
Oh, yeah, that's very important. And that's good for Ranchview to get a chance to, you know, a tight ball game and step up their line and hit the free throws.
Got them both. 7-point game with half a minute to go. Wagner had it blocked. Well, they were all over him, weren't they?
He tried to get the foul. But
Land will go to the free throw line.
That kind of forced that shot going in.
That's the 5th foul against Wagner.
Yeah, there could have been a foul called on that. But the officials do a good job. I'm not complaining.
So Land will go to the free throw line. And it appears that the Wolves will pick up win number 8 for the season, but more importantly, 3-0 in district.
Yeah, as long as Ranchview keeps hitting free throws. I mean, you know, if they had been missing free throws, North Hills would have had a chance to get back into it.
Land 3 for 3 on the line. In fact, only one free throw missed by this Wolf team in the second half.
Yeah, that's been a big difference, the way North Hills has come back.
And Land makes it perfect, 4 for 4 night from the free throw line. Waheed is still. Sit out to right. Richardson, Land. Land just holds on to it. They foul him with 15 seconds to go.
North Hills has done what they need to do to try to win the ball game. And Ranchview has just responded by doing what they need to do to win it by hitting the free throws. You kind of gamble a little bit. Well, we got a foul. They're going to shoot free throws. You're gambling that they're going to miss every now and then. You get the rebound and you get a chance to score.
5 free throws in a row for the 6'2 senior, Mikael Land. And he's 6 for 6.
Now, you don't want a stupid foul here.
Oh, you mean like that?
Like that. You got a 12-point lead. They're not going to beat you unless you just do something totally stupid.
And Coach Boyd's up. He doesn't get out of his chair very often. If he gets out of his chair,
you know you're in trouble.
There's a reason behind it. And he's telling Waheed right then and there, look, you don't have to foul him. 8 seconds to go, 12-point lead.
What's in he's saying, Coach, I didn't get him. I got the ball. He's going up here. I just went straight up. So.
And it was like a 3-point shot. So it's 3 free throws.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, lucky for him, Ali has missed the first 2. And he gets the 3rd one to fall. But That's going to do it. North Hills is just going to sit back, and the Wolves are going to rack up a win 62-51. All right. The Wolves win their third in a row. They're 3-0 in district. Stay with us. We'll wrap things up here on the ICTN Game of the Week. And welcome back, everyone. A victorious Ranchview fans heading for the exit, 62-51, the final score. And, Coach, talk about the game a little bit. You got out to a great start, and the shooters were hot, and then you kind of had to hold on there at the end.
Well, I don't know if we got off to a great start. We didn't get way behind, I'll admit that. But we found up making a few shots there in the end of the first quarter and the second quarter. We've been playing like that pretty much the second half of the season, picking spots to score. But that won't get it in the long run. We got to come out making buckets, and hopefully we can continue to make buckets throughout the game. We hit a, you know, we come out and we hit a few shots in a row, and we think we're rocking and rolling. And next thing you know, we can't buy a basket. And we got to buy a basket because our defense is what we call no defense.
I noticed in the second half you started driving the ball more. Was that just because of the defense they were giving you?
It was opportunity. We run a motion offense, and we give what they take us. And they was giving us, we had the opportunity to get to the basket.
I was watching during the game, and your big man, O'Paley, there at the beginning, is always wanting the ball inside.
Yeah.
But the perimeter guys kind of took over.
Well, a short story about him. He came over from Congo. I never played basketball. For 3 years, we didn't really think he will help us much. And this year, he turned out to be an excellent defender, rebounder. But let's just say I think most of the team know offense is not his strength, even though he's gotten better. So he might get a little upset that we don't give it to him, but I don't get too upset about it.
His job is to play
defense,
get rebounds,
you
right?
He don't leave the court. I mean, he's our best defender, our best rebounder, and his savvy of the game is excellent on the defensive end for sure.
Down the line, when it really counted, you guys made your free throws.
We did make some free throws, yeah. But down the line, we also made some crucial turnovers. We had forcing passes. We also had a guy, they was coming back, and we taking one pass, one shot. That's kind of our offense during the course of the game, but not the last 2 or 3 minutes when we're trying to save a win if possible.
Well, you did get one in your 3-0 in district play. It set up the big showdown when you do play AAA Academy. With that team, what do you got to do to beat someone like that?
Well, we got to hope that a couple of guys don't show up. hope that they disappear. You know, they got a big boy 6'9", and, you know, he's pretty decent, and they got another big guy about 6'6", and they got a couple of, even though height is not the main thing, but in their case, you know, they're not only big, but they also can play. If we knocking down our shots, I think most teams have proven that the three-pointers is an equalizer. So if we knock down shots, we can definitely compete.
All right. Well, you can compete so far. You're perfect in district play, so enjoy the win tonight.
Thank you, I will.
All right, that's D. Boy, the head coach of Ranchview. All right, let's go and take a look at the highlights here in the ball game. Player of the game by North Hills for sure had to be number one, Sebastian Wagner. This guy had 24 points on the night, and he was hitting them from everywhere, outside and inside, and drives to the hoop here and gets a three-point play with the foul. And because of his efforts, it was very close until right toward the end, but also some good play offensively for the Wolves, not necessarily always three-point shots. They can drive just as well. Daquan Waheed with a couple of those right through the paint. But they also can hit the three ball, and there is Land right there. Also some key free throws. He hit 6 out of 6 free throws down the stretch for 15 points. Scoring-wise, Wagner with 24. Ali had 16. Milhorn 6. Aquilo 4. And Henry had 1. That was a free throw. Land with 15. The big three, Land, Richardson, Wilson, carried this team offensively. Waheed with 8. Wright, Jones, Atkins, and O'Paley rounding out the scoring for these Wolves. So, Coach, your final thoughts on the game?
Well, we got to see a lot of three-pointer shots tonight. And, I think North Hills responded better than I thought they would. They did what they needed to do to get themselves in a position to win the ball game, but Ranchview responded and did what they needed. They hit the free throws. So I think it's a good ball game for both teams to carry out in the rest of the district.
That's right. And perfect right now is Ranchview, perfect in district play, setting up that big showdown with AAA Academy. Well, that's going to do it from here. A good game for the Wolves. A good game overall. A doubleheader. The Wolves win it. The guys win it. Also, the Lady Wolves win as well. So they're 2-0 in tonight's ball game here at Ranchview. So for Coach Juba Milton, Rob Willman with you, wishing you a pleasant good evening.
Irving Game of the Week has been brought to you in part by Gerald Stavely Dry Cleaning.